back for part three. Another beautiful day. Got time lapse going. Don't know how long it'll last. The sun's so blazing that even on time lapse, it ends up cutting out after a while. But we're going to mix up a few buckets and pour it on the floor and go ahead and coat, give one good coat to the floor up here. And then we'll work with some of the fabric to start, you know, touching up in areas and seeing how that works. So that's kind of what the agenda is today. So I'm gonna get the guy started up here, and then we'll see. I'm gonna try and work in the equipment room to get some things ready, but my days tend to get interrupted right now because other projects and stuff going on, but we'll try. All right, so let's mix one up. So this is mixed up 1-to-1. My other camera's up top, so I'm having to use the wide lens camera, but it's all right. Huh. You left us a big dookie turd. Yeah, like it's all right, I love it. See, it's gonna be great, Angela. All right, so that was like a 3/4 mix trialed on versus this is a pour it and brush it on. Just want to experiment with a couple different looks.
Okay.
Huh. All right. Squeezy. Oh, look at that. Man, we could roll this stuff with a brush roller.
Yep.
I mean, that probably pushes it down into the grooves a little better, but since my concrete guy screwed me over here. All right. If you need something done, send a woman to do it. We're just kind of brushing on one coat of this. Jeff is going around and brushing the corners. Get one coat in, and I mean, it'll already be dry. I'll come in and put a second coat. And,
second coat, we can go back and make, and do, take a little more time. And then as it starts to set up, we can go back to the wet trowel and actually smooth it down to look like glass.
I am fairly well now, I am strong, I am goodbye, I'm a long way from home. I am an orchard at the start of spring, I am a mockingbird, I love to sing, and I'm gonna fly, I'm gonna fly. I am an old road walking on my feet. I am laughing neath the weeping willow tree. I am a dog barking, a honeybee sting. I ain't no angel, but I've got my wings. 'cause I'm gonna fly. 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 Flesh and bones, I am a gunshot with a microphone. I'm a boy at the window as the summer sun sets. An old man in winter, nothing more, nothing less. I'm gonna fly. I'm gonna fly.
Back to the lower pool. They're scraping stuff up, vacuuming everything up, getting it clean. You see, we're all dry down here, no more leaks. We hadn't even put the fabric or anything on yet that actually seals it up on up. But we'll be doing that today, showing you how that goes on. All right, we're down here in the dungeon. We're 12 feet below lake level.
Oh, that pool is a quarter trainer.
Yeah, this isn't gonna be a pool.
And it finishes here. Two men enter, one man leaves.
All right, pray tell, what exciting thing are we working with next?
Fabric.
Okay. Woo-hoo! So it looks like a big, not, well, the other ones look like rolls of toilet paper. This is more like paper towels, I guess. But it's a fabric. See that?
Ooh.
All right.
All right. So what we're going to do is we're going to wrap a perimeter with it. Anywhere that basically there's going to be a seam or a joint is where we're going to add. So the areas that have usually the leaking or where moisture, but you know, can have the issues is where we're gonna actually in the end have double fabric.
Gotcha.
So once we wrap this and get everything done and the pipes and all that, then we'll start the 40-inch fabric and start basically encapsulating the entire pool with that. So these problem areas with that, these areas we'll add fabric to first just to make sure that there's a double layer of it. And then encapsulate and yeah.
All right. So we got our gookity goop.
Yep, it's a 1-to-1 mix.
Full 1-to-1 mix.
So it is a nice, disgusting looking slurry.
All right. At least it's not doo doo brown.
No.
Okay.
Here, especially on longer rolls.
Okay.
You're gonna go in and you're gonna set it. And then you're literally just gonna go up. One of the things is you wanna make sure it stays wet. And
okay.
In this heat, that's gonna be fun.
All right, and humidity, the challenge.
Yeah.
You think the humidity would help us, but it never does.
Yeah. So once you set it, you wanna make sure it's like in the edges and up. Smooth as you can, and if you get what it's doing where it's not wanting to connect, just keep it wet.
Well, you'll go a little faster when you're not having to show me what to do. Oh, look at that! Huh.
right at the edge.
Okay. As you can see, we're gonna mess around and try and find the most efficient way to get this going. So you see, you just keep rolling that on along.
So right here, you can see where we did a cut.
Yeah.
Because it was...
I gotcha.
It wasn't able to lay, which in certain situations is okay.
Right.
Because we're gonna have another piece of fabric.
Yeah, that comes down, right. So stuff like that, if y'all go back to the original videos when we were pouring this, we had an issue to where we had to move the entire pool this way, and we had already put some gravel in the back for drainage, and just, you know, that was one of those little mistakes. This is at the bottom of the pool, it's 12 feet deep. Not a big deal, but just something to keep in mind when you're doing the one-sided forms. You saw we learned from our mistakes, so when we moved from here to up there, we put more strips on. So we had the strips going that kind of locked each panel together because they come in 8-foot pieces. But you see, if you let them, they will bend in a little bit, and then you've got stuff like that that you've got to fix on the end, bodywork. Not the end of the world. We can take and float that out, and we will as we go up, but obviously, if you can make less work for yourself, that's what you want to do. And less work would be on the front end, making sure those are all strapped. I'll post a link to the video, so if you're someone looking at doing this yourself and you want to see what I'm talking about, so you can zoom in on that and see where that could have gone a little better. So that's going to be pretty cool. We will be ready for concrete in there.
Hello?
Hello? You sure have become sneaky.
Jackie Dash has arrived.
Jackie Dash! It was so hot the GoPro wouldn't work.
Oh my goodness.
But I'm out here. That seems smart.
It seems okay.
Huh. Alright, well. It's getting there. Are you excited? You haven't seen me yet.
Can I swim on it? Can I swim in it by this weekend?
If you don't want it to be be chlorinated.
No.
I just dump palm water in there and you can swim in it.
Absolutely not. You know I want chlorine.
Yeah. Well.
You know I like toxic chemicals invading into my body.
Yeah. No, we got ways for that. Well, you see what happened to the last person that waited on when we were going to swim?
I know. Look at the poor guy.
Yeah.
Pitiful.
He'll be out. I want to see if you can get it done.
Now I'm not paying attention.
It's because you were blinded by my beauty.
Yeah.
I think she laughed. All right, food.
Please stop. We're losing everything left in the bucket.
Okay, stop.
All right, well, keep. You want me to put food down there or you want to just wait?
We're almost
done.
Okay. Well, day's over. Everybody's been gone for a while. We set a new record for the high temp today. And in the beginning of the week in the 80s, that was doable, no problem. It's been brutal. Really the last 3 days, especially the last 2 days. And it's just, forget it. I don't care. We're not gonna kill ourselves over a couple days. Next week's gonna be a lot cooler, so that's great. As you can see, we got the bottom around there done. Now, in my case, this was overkill because we poured the pool monolithically, which means that we poured the floor at the same time, so actually it's not a cold joint there. But this lets us clean it up and make the corner a little smoother, and it shows everybody that's watching, especially if it's somebody who wants to do their own that's not doing monolithic, what you would have to do. So. Showing some extra steps just so you know. We got to clean up tools and everything. This is ready for the fabric also. So starting Monday, we're gonna start draping the fabric on all the walls and get that in. And then after that, it's just two coats and we're done, except for whatever color we want to finish in, but not too bad. Like I said, except for the heat, there really haven't been a lot of hours put into it. And, you know, been training and stuff like that. So training, filming, showing what you do. I mean, like a crew that has done this before comes out and just knock it out. But, yeah. All right, ready to get this done and pumping water. So, you wouldn't have seen the video because I decided I've got enough footage to do it in its own separate one, but I'll show you the sneak peek of what it's going to end up like is my little floor box there. Going to lower that just a little bit more, move some of the gravel, and then run those four in, drive the ground rods, bam, and tie a rebar. We got the rebar cut, it's going to be tight, and we're ready for concrete in there. We'll tie a rebar for up here, we'll be ready for concrete. Chris is coming Saturday to dig the footings. Then Josh and I are doing the rebar in there. So Tuesday morning, we've got a footing inspection and then pour concrete Tuesday afternoon or Wednesday. Whenever Casey schedules, let him. He can come in here and go ahead and build the retaining walls. Let those set up, cure at least 7 days. Then we'll be able to put our rock and backfill, what I'm looking for, and go ahead and get rid of all the dirt that we're going to. And then we'll know what dirt we have left to go back in the back and raise that road up like I've talked about before. So that's the big picture on everything. Appreciate you as always. See you in the next one.